Today we are going to learn about a famous astronaut named Sunita Williams, who was born on 19 September 1965 in Ohio, United States. She is an American astronaut and US Navy officer who formerly held the records for total spacewalks by a woman and most spacewalk time, which is 50 hours 40 minutes for a woman. She was assigned to the International Space Station as a member. Actually, International Space Station is a modular spacecraft capable of supporting a human crew in orbit. So let's learn about her through this chapter. 10 December 2006 at 7:17 a.m. our time, the Space Shuttle Discovery lifted off from Kennedy Space Center, Houston, Texas, USA. Aboard it, along with other members of the flight crew, was Sunita Williams. 2 days later, 354 kilometers in space above Bangladesh, she entered the International Space Station, her home for the next 6 months. Tally-ho on the new home was her first message to Earth. Sunita was born Sunita Pandya in the state of Ohio in the USA. Her father's family is from Gujarat and her mother is Slovenian. Her parents spoke different languages and ate different types of food. Since her father was a strict vegetarian, her mother had to cook two meals every day. A vegetarian meal for the father and eggs, meat and fish for the rest of the family. The children were encouraged to try both. Having an Asian father and a European mother and being educated in American schools helped Sunita understand that we are all part of one world. It does not matter where we live as long as we are given the opportunity to do what we really want to do. Sunita's parents, Deepika Pandya and Bonnie Pandya, gave her exactly that. After high school, Sunita joined the US Naval Academy to pursue a Bachelor of Science degree. Here, she met her future husband, Michael Williams. After her graduation, she joined the Navy as an aviator and was soon flying Navy helicopters. During one of her field trips to the Johnson Space Center, she happened to listen to a talk by a veteran astronaut, John Young. Young mentioned that he learned to fly a copter in order to land the lunar lander. Yes, so after 2 days of travel from Kennedy Space Center, Houston, United States, Sunita Williams reached to International Space Station along with other flight crew members, where they are going to spend next 6 months of their life. Sunita was born Sunita Pandya. Her father's name is Deepak Pandya. He is from Gujarat, India, while her mother is a Slovenian named Bonnie Pandya. She was born and brought up in between the completely different culture. Her mixed parentage and education in America helped her realize that it does not matter where one lives. We are all part of the same world, and as long as we are given opportunity to pursue our interest, we can make the most of it. After completing her graduation from US Naval Academy, she joined the Navy as an aviator. During one of her field trip to Johnson Space Center, she once listened to a very experienced astronaut, John Young, talking about learning to fly a copter in order to land the lunar lander, which inspired her to train and become an astronaut, and it was a turning point in her life. To the next one, Sunita was fascinated. Why can't I be an astronaut? She thought. So she applied to the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, that is NASA, going into space needs years of very hard training. Traveling to space is an extraordinary experience. Astronauts have to prepare for the sudden change from Earth to space, far away from the gravitational pull of the Earth. The spacecraft makes you weightless. Astronauts float around inside the spacecraft in their weightless state. Even the simple task of squeezing toothpaste out of a tube in that atmosphere needs training. The strip of paste will simply float around and will not stick to the toothbrush. It is the same with everything you do. In the spacecraft, Sunita had to be pulled down and held firmly for a group photograph. Yes, so as per this paragraph, Sunita Williams applied for NASA, but just applying is not sufficient for becoming an astronaut. They have to undergo a very hard training in which they are prepared how to manage themselves for the sudden change from Earth to space. Even when they are in their weightless state in the spacecraft, how to do the day-to-day course of their life. And Sunita Williams successfully passed that training. So, come to the next one. One of the first things that she did in the shuttle before entering the ISS was to have fellow astronaut John Higginbotham cut her ponytail. I sort of wanted a picture of what it looked like when I had really long hair in space. And so I did get that picture taken. She said when asked why she had not cut off before going to space. The shorn hair was donated to Lock of Love, a US-based charitable organization that provides hair prosthesis to disadvantaged children suffering from permanent hair loss caused by cancer, radiation treatment, or burns. During her stay, Sunita performed several experiments inside the ISS, but she was most excited about the spacewalks she took outside it. She spent 9 days, 29 hours and 17 minutes in space outside the space station. When she did that, she broke the previous record held by Catherine C. Thornton for the most spacewalk time by a woman. This record has now been broken, but a record for the longest uninterrupted space flight by a woman is yet to be overtaken. She traveled in space for 194 days, 18 hours and 15 minutes. Do astronauts work all the time while in space? No. Sunita spent her leisure time much the same way we all do. She relished the paneer, samosas, chapatis and other Indian dishes she had carried with her. She wrote a blog, sent emails, spoke to her family and friends, and talked to people around the world. She also watched the sunrise, which happened as many as 15 times a day. She was very happy talking to school children in the US, Italy, India, and Spain. Yes, so according to this para, what is the first thing Sunita do in the shuttle before entering to International Space Station is to cut off her fellow astronaut John Higginbotham's ponytail, and that devoted hair was donated to US-based charitable organization Lock of Love. And this organization provides artificial hair to all those people who are suffering from permanent hair loss because of cancer or any radiation treatment or burns. During her stay in the space station, she made record of spending 9 days, 29 hours and 17 minutes in space outside the space station by breaking the previous record of Catherine C. Thornton. She traveled in space for 194 days, 18 hours and 15 minutes. During Sunita's free time, she loved to eat Indian dishes that she carried with her, wrote a blog, sent emails, talked to people around the world, and to watch the sunrise. But she was happy to talk with school kids of different countries. Come to the next one. Here are some interesting questions from children around the world, followed by Sunita's answers. Sunita answered these questions from the space station. What can you see in outer space? Is it very dark? The most spectacular things you can see in space is our planet Earth. You actually see the whole planet. Imagine that. We live in a beautiful place. How long does it take to get to the ISS? It took about 8.5 minutes to get to space. You have to go out of the Earth's atmosphere. After that, it is about 2 days to get to the space station. The space station is already there in space. We had to align our shuttle to connect to the station. It is like tying up your small boat to a large moving ship so you can climb aboard. This takes a little bit of time. What is your favorite food in space? Peanut butter and marshmallow on a tortilla. It's my favorite on Earth too. What do you miss the most? My dog Gorby, a Jack Russell Terrier. What's one of the best thing about being in space? The fact that you never need to get a ladder to reach things. I can just slide myself into the position I need, including standing on my head if it helps. What should we do to become an astronaut? Study a lot of maths and science. Of course, English is important. But you will not have a problem. Take care of your health. Do not take it for granted, because 98% of the tests are medical in nature and only 2% are interviews. What did you learn while up there? The Earth is a large and beautiful body with no boundaries or dividing lines. It's hard to understand why anyone would argue about particular regions on this planet, let alone fight over them. What advice would you give to those who wants to follow in your footsteps? I think if anybody wants to be an astronaut, they can be. Just keep this in mind, pick the job you want to do and do it well. We are looking for people with training in different occupations, people with different skills to be astronauts. Secondly, keep yourself in good health. You have to be very fit to go into a space. So, according to this para, lots of students ask variety of questions from Sunita Williams, like about her favorite foods, what she miss most in the space, etc. And Sunita loved to reply them. From among all, one of the students asked her that what they have to do to become an astronaut. So she simply advised to study a lot of maths, science and English. Pick the job that they want to and do well in that job, and must take care of their health. So kids, what we learned from the life story of Sunita Williams? To grasp the opportunity when you get, study a lot, pick the job that you want to and give your best in that job. Then only you can enjoy your life in a better way. And secondly, not to compromise with your health. Thank you.